concerning Lalaji and the value tree of beliefs on the Sufi heart. I am just waiting for the time to be ready to start the volume 3. Volume 3 will take into account the current masters. However, Lalaji Razi Allah Ta'ala Unhu, with him begins the Ramchandriya Tarika. So inclusion of the names of his disciples in volume 3 will not be possible because of the scope. Otherwise, the volume will become, the volume 3 will become very voluminous. So there we will have to give the concise works of Lalaji, Chachaji, Sufi Brahmohan Lal and Sufi Omkar Nath. However, there will be another book on Ram, the Lalaji's Nisbat. The work of Lalaji needs to be highlighted in a different way. And it has to be, the whole strategy is clear in my mind, but the title I have not chosen. Lalaji, the Ramchandriya Tarikat or something like that, where in details, along with my insights, the work of Lalaji will come. And when we are talking about the work of Lalaji, it is not only Dr. Sri Krishna Lal, but all the disciples of Lalaji and the other masters who have deviated. No one tells you or stops you from doing the work, but you have to recognize that Lalaji is the main master of Ramchandriya Tarika. Maulana Fazl Ahmad Khan did not bestow the authority on his son. Lalaji did not bestow the authority on his son, Mahatma Jagmohan Narayan. What is the fuss about all this? That he is Lalaji's son. So what, Mauli Sahab's son, we give due respect, but he is not the master, the sheikh of the tariqah. The authority, the entire sheikhhood was bestowed on Sufi Brijmohan Lal, not even on Chachaji. But Chachaji worked alongside. The two have the respect for one another. Chachaji had tremendous respect for Mahatma Brijmohan Lal, saying that in him I see the image of Lalaji Razi Allah Ta'ala. And Sufi Brijmohan Lal respected Chachaji, not as his father, but the younger brother of Chachaji. But this was not the case with the immediate descendants of Lalaji Razi Allah Ta'ala. And Sufi Jaidevi, the wife of Chachaji, used to say, you go there and nobody pays you any respect, nobody even asks about you, and you go there. He said, that does not matter. This is a realm of bhaiya, my brother, I have to go there. And then, I am not sure, it is also said that Mahatma Jagmohan Narayan has the hitch in his mind that the authority, whatever is the status of Lala of Mahatma Brijmohan Narayan, that is Mahatma Brijmohan Lal Razi Allah Ta'ala Unho, is not his status. But apparently what Sufi Brijmohan Lal has mentioned in that, he mentioned of tremendous love and respect on the part of Mahatma Jagmohan Narayan for his elder brother, cousin Sufi Brijmohan Lal. And after the separation, after Mahatma Brajmohan Lal moved away from the place that he had been in the name of his father, and because of the conflict with his brothers, he had moved away to a very dilapidated, small place in the same town. And when in 1943-44, Mahatma Jagmohan Narayan was suffering from some ailment, and he has to come to for the treatment, he came and stayed with his cousin Sufi Brijmohan Lal Raziyallahu Ta'ala. And the respect that he had for the Sufi Brijmohan Lal and Shakuntala Devi, Sufi Omkar Nath had mentioned that it is from him he learned how to pay respect to the parents. So these things has to be put. However, the sons of Mahatma Jagmohan Narayan, first Akhilesh Kumar and then Dinesh Kumar, they continued to remain in separation from the ministry, considering that he is the grandson of Lalaji, not Sufi Omkar Nath. But they defied the wish of Lalaji Raziyallahu Ta'ala. And in 1973, it was the birth anniversary, 100th birth anniversary of Lalaji Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu. So in the month of February, that's the birthday anniversary was falling. And the same time, this around the same date, the function at the shrine of Chachaji Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu used to take place. And this was the function that was started by Chachaji Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu out of his love for his brother Lalaji. So this is very important. But Akhilesh Kumar did not agree with that, and he, along with his mother, conspired, I would have to use this very strong word, conspired to have the function celebrated at the shrine of Lalaji. Whereas Sufi Omkar Nath and Shakuntala Devi, the concert of Sufi Brijmohan Lal, said that it is during the Easter month, when there is a function at the shrine of Lalaji, we will celebrate the anniversary. And which is more appropriate, but it was not acceptable. And he was trying to put himself that he is the grandson of Lalaji, and Sufi Omkar Nath is the grandson of Chachaji. So naturally his status is higher. And whenever he used to come in the spiritual gatherings, he used to sit down. He was given the status to sit down along with Sufi Omkar Nath. But he never had the capacity to speak or to have discourse. So he was trying to use Lalaji as a prop that he is the grandson of Lalaji Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu, so he has to be given respect. Respect is given for what you are, not what is your inheritance, what you actually represent, what you have gained. And as a result, all these masters who started their own shops, which includes the Sahaj Mark, the Ramchandra Mission, who cannot even speak a single sentence, and he completely cut off himself from the shrine of Lalaji. And at the time of Lalaji's the Samadhi Day, when Lalaji's cremation body was to be cremated, that time there was a gossip who will be the next master, and they defied the wish of Lalaji Raziyallahu Ta'ala. Then all these people, now Ramchandra, that is the from Sahaj Mark or SR, whatever it is, Ramchandra Mission, he needed a prop to propagate himself as the descendant, as the true inheritor of Lalaji Raziyallahu Ta'ala Unhu. And Dinesh Kumar needed a prop, a support where he is given respect. He was never interested in spirituality. I had known him during his heydays when he was working in the railway services. There was not apparently no interest Occasionally he will come in the at the shrine of Sufi Brij Mohan Lal, but not on a regular. At times I have seen Akhilesh Kumar, his elder brother, at the shrine, but after 1973 I don't recall him coming in at that shrine, because that time the from 1968 or 69 to 1979 and so, I remain the main person organizing that spiritual function. So I know it very well that he did not come. So Ramchand Mission needed a prop saying that Lalaji's grandson is on my side, and he needed a prop, a respect, so that he can claim that he is Lalaji's son, and due respect that is needed. But the respect comes out of your being, what you have attained to, what you are. Then Dr. Chaturbhuj Sahai, another disciple of Lalaji, Dr. Har Narayan, Maharaj Narayan, that is son-in-law of Lalaji Razi Allah Ta'ala Unho. All these, there is mention of all these disciples of Lalaji into that. And Dr. Chaturbhuj Sahai, he completely cut off, all these people cut off from the main source. If there is a tributary of Ganges or Hudson or any main river, and that it is cut off from the main reservoir, main source, then where will it get its supply from? This is what Nisbat is, and this is what the, but the thing is this, the, in the divine scheme, everybody has a role to do. There are various restaurants in, even in Scotland, that are selling pasta or the same thing, but their standards are different, because everyone has to live. Someone's food is of an A grade, and then the others is of a lower grade, but all of them have a right to live. So in that case, because it is happening, I have to be in harmony with that, but at the same time the true color has to be brought out. And this cannot be done in volume 3 of Leaves from the Sufi Heart. This has to be done, Lalaji, something of, and the Naqshbandiya Tariqa, and the Ramchandiya Tariqa. Then it will come in Ramchandiya Tariqa, Sufi Brij Mohan Lal, although the he is the part of Naqshbandi, Mujaddadi, Majhariya, or Ramchandriya Tariqat, but all these other people, they only have the connection with Lalaji and not with the Naqshbandi Nisbat. So they will come under Naqshbandi as Ramchandriya Tariqat, and it has to be mentioned very clearly the role of every individual. There is one person, he is known as Yashpal Gupta. They were two brothers, Yashpal Gupta and Satpal Gupta. They were disciples of Sufi Brij Mohan Lal. After the Samadhi of Sufi Brij Mohan Lal, Yashpal completely separated from him, and then he never came. He never came at the shrine. In my 20 years of stay, I have never seen him. And it's said that they are had respect for my mother and so, but they never came to meet Mama or anyone, because everybody was feeling offended that a young Omkarna at the age of 17 or 21 is given the bestowed the masterhood. One has to see the inner capabilities of Omkar. Not that he is the son of Sufi Brij Mohan Lal. And then his younger brother Satpal, he still comes, and he maintained his relation with his brother, because that was his blood brother, but he maintained his complete association with Shakuntala Devi, Sufi Omkarnath, and the people, and he still comes. He lives in the same city where Sufi Brij Mohan Lal's shrine is, that is Lucknow. So he is a little far away, he has retired from the government job and he comes on the special occasions, and I understand that he comes on Sunday morning, because Thursday afternoon is in the evening meditation, and he, since he lives far away, and I guess he would be around 70s or even more, so he may not drive to come down in the night, but in the morning he comes. So all these masters, the people who claim to be doing the work, what is very important, through your work, through your presence, through your being, the fragrance of Lalaji should come. There is a particular person, I will not recall his name, he is from England. When Dinesh Kumar Saxena, he told me about him, so I sent him a message. Then he said he has his guru and he don't need anybody. Okay, I have no problem with that. Then recently now he is calling me, because when he is seeing the book and there is no one else amidst the descendants of Lalaji or Chachaji or Sufi Brijmohan Lal, who has so much of work to his credit. So he calls me and he told me, so my role is not to be anybody's guru who is interested in knowing the inner secrets of the path. My doors are open. What will I, and ultimately I know there is no master-disciple relationship. This is simply a game, a scheme. Until you have not attained, I have to remain, and the day you attain, there is no difference between me and you, because your awareness is at that level. Now it will start happening that even for small things, your own understanding is capable of handling these small affairs. So this is why, and nobody stops you. How can you stop a candle from spreading its light? And how can you stop a flower spreading its beauty and fragrance? But what is important, the candle has to be lit, the flower has to blossom. A bud cannot spread its beauty and fragrance. A seed cannot spread its beauty and fragrance. An unlit candle cannot spread its beauty and fragrance. First and the foremost thing is, important thing is that you have to attain, you have to be a light unto yourself. And when you are light unto yourself, then when you have blossomed, the flower has blossomed, the bees will start gathering around. The moth will start coming around as soon as the lamp, your candle is lit. This is what is important. And I want to keep my doors open. I have people who are coming from different traditions. The Christian, the Sufi, the other Sufi paths, the Maharashtrian, Bhakti, all these. So this is my role, to help all those people who are at different paths. Just a few days ago, Hemant from Mumbai has sent me something on Nyandev, that is Sant Gyaneshwar's sister, Muktabai's compositions, which is 11 compositions. And now you can see that the person knows when it is given to me, a true justice will be done. He asked me that he has translated these avangs, what I want to do with it. So I told him we will create a work on Muktabai, and it was only yesterday it started, and I am now on 59th page. This will be, all those compositions will be taken into account as meditation techniques. A very simple word, but very melodious word. And the entire story goes on when the parents of Nyandev was insulted and disrespected and ostracized by the society and the priestly community, the father, the parents, they drowned themselves at the confluence and died. Then these teens, the three brothers and one sister, they were disowned and they had to live on the alms and nobody was willing to accept. So Nyandev was very much upset with this, so he decided to enter into samadhi, and so he shut himself into the hut. And his brother Nivritti, who was his guru, he persuaded him, but nothing happened. The younger brother Sopan persuaded him, nothing happened. Then Muktabai, she was meditating on the bank of the river Indrani in Pune, where in January I happened to visit along with Anil Sohani and Hemant Moge at the shrine of these masters. So she came and she told, she sang these abhangs, these compositions which were a spontaneous beauty. Abhang means, means not. Bhang means disturbed, that which is not disturbed, that which is not broken, the unbroken, the spontaneous. And now, unless you are a light unto yourself, the moment, nothing can happen. The moment you, as long as you are holding a torchlight in your hand, your room will not be lighted. The moment you change the bulb and turn on the in the socket and you turn off the switch, the whole room is filled with the light. And then every nook and corner of that will be filled. This is when you are a light unto yourself. Then whatever comes in front of you, that gets illuminated. Whether it is Sant Gyaneshwar's Haripat or it is Muktabai's Tatiche. Tatiche means Tati means door, Che means of, the songs of the door. And this is very significant. Maharashtrians considering it that Muktabai sang the songs requesting, pleading Nyandev to open the door. That is the Tatiche, the songs of the door. But the deeper meaning is whenever a tradition or something happens, it is happening at the gross level. It is physically happening. Thereafter, now neither Nyandev is available, nor those circumstances and situations are available, nor Muktabai is available, but the situation is there. You are at the threshold. You are at the door. You have not entered in. The master pleads you to enter into the cave of eternity. This is what the significance has to be given. Now, when you look at Bhagavad Gita, there had been two wars. The first, the war took place between Ram and Ravan in Ramcharitmanas. This is between two countries. Then, during the time of Krishna, the war happened between two cousins, the Kaurav and Pandavas. During Buddha time, things have changed. It refers to inner war. The inner war that goes on in every seeker. Unless and until we overcome that inner war, nothing is going to happen. So it is in this light, the role of the master, role of those people who are working. It is not merely accumulating the people. What is my gain? You look at it, what is my gain? Nothing. And all these people, they are, my maid who used to work in my house and the house of the people from Ramchandra Mission, she was the same. You know what she used to say? That he has gone to Madras to collect donations. That is how their source of income is. My source of income is my work that I do. This is what Lalaji had said and Maulvi Sahab had said. Maulana Fazl Ahmad Khan Sahab, do your official work, earn your livelihood, and then do the divine work. So it is not that you have to live on that alms, live on the donations or the charities or the what you call offerings that comes to the place. And in the spiritual functions, whatever offering used to come, that used to be spent on those people who cannot afford to pay their passage to come to the spiritual function. The money orders used to be sent to them to come to this function. And sometimes when the person is leaving, he is given some money and some things like that. This is how Shakuntala Devi had lived her life. This is how I know each time when there was a deficit budget after the function, it used to be fulfilled out of the salary of Sufi Omkarnath. Then later on, some of the disciples of Sufi Omkarnath, they were very generous and they became a part of that. And so whenever there is a shortfall or deficit after the program, after the spiritual function, they used to contribute. And that too was not made public that you have to pay X amount. And the arrangement for 3 days for people to stay there and to eat food, all that was being made out of this. Not that it is an obligation that I am coming. When I travel, go to Boston or those places, I spend my traveling. The only thing is those people allow me to stay at their house. So there is no expense of staying. But otherwise, I have to follow the tradition of Maulvi Fazl Ahmad Khan, Lala Ji Razi Allah Ta'ala Unhu, Sufi Chacha Ji Razi Allah Ta'ala Unhu, Sufi Brij Mohan Lal, Sufi Omkarnath. And then, if those people do not want to maintain relation with me, or because of jealousy, because of so much of my work is there, or feel offended because that I might take away the people, some disciples, it does not matter to me. I am here to do my work, what I am ordained to do, and what I am capable of doing. Imagine that a book of 200 pages finishes in a week's time. Can you tell me any author who can write a book of that nature of 200, 300 pages and finishes in a week's time?